what we call the secret master plan. So.
Hey, this is Warren Redlich. I am really excited about what Tesla has coming in terms of new vehicles in the future. Tesla has been working on a lineup of sexy cars, the Model S, the Model 3, which is an E, the Model X and the Model Y. Cybertruck is coming, that's C. R for Roadster, S for Semi, and the big question mark is what's going to go in the A slot. A lot of people have speculated it's going to be the ATV that was unveiled at the Cybertruck reveal. I don't think so. So let's talk about what the Model A or the Model 4 might be. Are you ready? Let's go.
Hey, this is my friend Joe.
A battery electric airplane enthusiast who inspires kids. Check out jndsupport.com in the description for your IT needs. In Shanghai, at the Model 3 delivery ceremony, Elon talked about how Tesla was going to open up a China design center.
Super cool. So we're going to do a great China design and engineering center to actually design an original car in China for worldwide consumption.
And at that China Design Center, they would develop a new model, China Design, that would be, for the future, a world car. This is a contrast from the master plan, the second master plan, or I'll do my best French pronunciation, part deux. Elon specifically said that there wouldn't be anything smaller than the Model 3. This kind of conflicted with the idea that Tesla has of spreading the vehicles into all market segments.
Part two of the master plan, to expand to all of the major vehicle segments in order to, as quickly as possible, move us away from oil.
His comments in Shanghai and his tweet about a German designed vehicle suggest that he's changed his mind. And I think it only makes sense that Tesla will make smaller, less expensive vehicles because the goal is to accelerate the transition to sustainable energy and smaller vehicles with, in particular, smaller battery packs that will accelerate the transition. So today we're going to talk about what the A vehicle is in sexy cars. Will it be the Model A? I don't think so, because Ford has a trademark on the Model A. Will it be the Model A? Or will it be the Model 4, as some of my commenters suggested, that a 4 would fit in the A slot, just like the Model 3 fits in the E slot. For purposes of this video, I'm going to refer to it as the Model 4. As for styling, that's over my head. I don't feel comfortable saying what I think the styling will be. China will do what China will do. It will be some kind of Chinese design. I'm excited about that. Elon also mentioned in a tweet that there might have a German design vehicle to handle European roads, that some people feel the Model Y is still too big for European roads. I don't know why you would have two different vehicles, one designed in China and one designed in Europe. I think Elon knows what he's doing. If Elon thinks it's the right thing to do, he's probably got a good idea what he's doing. If you're going to be producing millions of these vehicles, it certainly makes sense to have multiple designs of these vehicles. The biggest goal is get the cost down, get the cost of manufacture down, as much as possible, get the pack size down, because if you get the pack size down, you can produce more vehicles, you can accomplish more in terms of that, accelerating that transition to sustainable energy. And of course, by doing so, you dramatically increase Tesla's profits and make that share price go through the roof. It's important to stress here, the goal is not high performance driving. In a robo-taxi world, we don't want our vehicles accelerating harshly, making sharp turns, slamming on the brakes, and showing us how many G-forces they can do. That's fun for us when we're driving the vehicle. When we're sitting in the back of the vehicle going somewhere, we don't want those sudden movements. We want the vehicle to be calm. We want it to be a pleasant ride. Harsh acceleration, high-performance driving reduces range. Robo-taxi network is going to want its vehicles to maximize range. They're going to drive in chill mode. They're going to drive in a mode that maximizes the range. An important thing to think about for achieving these goals, it has to do with vehicle efficiency. If you look at this chart of vehicle efficiency, you'll see that Teslas are the top. They have the lowest efficiency ratio. It's the second column from the right. That's the critical column. You can see that the Audi e-tron has got an 8.3 efficiency ratio. That's kilowatt hours over range over weight. That the Teslas have gotten down from the Model S standard range, they've gotten, you know, increasingly better numbers down to the best number so far is the Tesla Model Y long-range rear-wheel drive has an efficiency ratio of 5.8. The column to the right is watt-hours per mile. The Tesla Model 3 Standard Range Plus has the best if watt hours per mile number getting close to 200 watt hours per mile. If Tesla can get the efficiency ratio significantly lower than that 5.8 number, getting it down to 5.6, 5.5 or better, if Tesla can make a vehicle that weighs 2,500 pounds, then they can get watt hours per mile down much lower to maybe 150 or less. And that will mean you can get 200 miles of range or close to it on a 25 kilowatt hour battery pack. You really need to get it down to 125 watt hours per mile. But maybe if you can get 180 miles of range, that's good enough. Why is 180 or 200 miles of range good enough? We as Tesla fans, as people who want to own Teslas, we want a vehicle with more range. But the purpose of these vehicles is no longer about what we want for our car that we're keeping in our garage. The purpose of these vehicles is for the robo-taxi network. If you have a vehicle with 180 miles of range in its pack, and you drive it on an average of 20 miles an hour during the day, and you do 8 hours of driving in the morning into the afternoon, at 20 miles an hour, you've gone 160 miles. That's within the 180 mile pack. And then you charge it in the middle of the day when there's a little bit of lull, you find a moment, you charge it, and you go out for another 8 hours, and you do another 160 miles, and you've covered 320 miles that day. You've transported a lot of people where they needed to go, and you did it all on that 180 mile pack. Maybe a 200 mile pack if you can get there, but 180 mile pack should be enough for a lot of what the robo-taxi network is designed to do. By reducing the battery pack to 25 kilowatt hours instead of 50 kilowatt hours or higher, you're doubling the number of vehicles that Tesla can make. By doubling the number of vehicles that Tesla makes, you expand the robo-taxi network. You expand the learning, so the robo-taxi network dojo, the software learns faster and becomes a better driver faster. So three scenarios I see for the Tesla Model 4 rear-wheel drive. One scenario that I think is the most likely is a 2,500-pound weight, a 25-kilowatt-hour battery pack, an efficiency ratio of 5.6, which is only slightly better than the efficiency ratio in the Tesla Model Y. That gets watt-hours per mile down to 140. So if you have a 25-kilowatt-hour pack, at 140 watt hours per mile, you get 180 miles of range on your 2,500 pound vehicle. If you go to a 30 kilowatt hour pack, which might make a lot of sense, if you can get a slightly better efficiency ratio, you get the watt hours per mile to 143, not quite 140. Your weight is 2,600 pounds because the extra 5 kilowatt hours of battery weighs something. You get to an EPA range of 210 miles, which is better. Again, for what we want in our garage for our personal vehicle, we want more range. But that's us. For certain markets like China and India and Africa, it may very well be that a 200-mile range is plenty for what most people are doing. And for the robo-taxi network, that 200 miles of range is great. I am projecting that the goal is to have a smaller battery pack, and that will enable you to get more vehicles on the road. The Model 4 will have a curb weight of around 2,500 pounds or 1,130 kilograms. That lighter weight will enable the vehicle to go farther on a watt hour of electricity. By reducing the cost of manufacturing, by reducing the amount of batteries needed, by making it more in a more efficient manner, Tesla will be able to get the cost of this vehicle down as low as $10,000 to produce. Currently, the Model 3, Model Y, they're around $30,000 to produce. They believe they're going to be able to get the production cost down to $25,000.
So the current cost of Model 3 robo-taxi is less than $38,000. We expect that number to improve over time. Okay, maybe it ends up being $25,000 or less.
But if you go with a smaller, lighter vehicle, with a smaller battery pack, and you produce it in higher volume, you're able to spread the capital expenditures, the CapEx, over more vehicles. That will reduce the cost, and they can get the cost of an individual vehicle, their cost, Tesla's cost, down to $10,000, and maybe sell that vehicle for $15,000, if they sell them at all. I think Tesla's going to stop selling cars. Check out this video, where I explain why Tesla's going to stop selling cars. The Model 4 will be a hyper-efficient, smaller, four-passenger compact utility vehicle. The target will be 200 miles of range. I know this is surprising. People are used to talking about getting longer range, But I am predicting that this vehicle will only need 200 miles of range, might even be as low as 180 miles of range. Why does this matter? Tesla has been battery constrained for a long time. They're just not producing enough batteries to produce all the vehicles they want to get to. So, if they are able to produce vehicles with smaller battery packs, that will enable them to make more vehicles. Right now, a typical Tesla has a 50 kilowatt hour battery pack. The Model 3 and the Model Y both start around 50 kilowatt hours. If Tesla is able to make a vehicle with a 25 kilowatt hour battery pack, they'll be able to make twice as many vehicles. That's the key. You want more vehicles on the road because more vehicles makes the robotaxi network more viable. More vehicles on the road, more electric vehicles on the road takes more ICE vehicles off the road. It accelerates the transition to sustainable energy and transportation. A smaller, lighter vehicle will be easier to produce. With Tesla's advances in manufacturing, with streamlined manufacturing, with the Model Y's whole frame casting, possibly with a stainless steel body that doesn't use paint, maybe a softer, thinner steel than what they're using in Cybertruck that might allow some limited stamping or pressing. I predict that when Tesla gets this Model A or Model 4 going in China, because of the streamlined manufacturing, because of the reduced size of the vehicle, and because of the smaller battery pack, a single gigafactory or terafactory will be able to produce 2 million vehicles a year from just one factory. So this is where we're heading. With a revolution in automotive body engineering that Elon has talked about for Berlin, with whole frame casting that we've talked about before that's going to be used in the Model Y and will be used in the Model 4, with smaller battery packs, with smaller vehicles, with reduced manufacturing costs, with reduced material costs, with increased production, we're going to see the Tesla Model 4 is going to be a massive, massive change in Tesla's production and a massive change in how the world operates vehicles. It's a massive acceleration, a step change toward sustainable energy in transportation and otherwise in our world. It's going to be fantastic. If you want to learn more about why Tesla is going to stop selling cars, check out this video. If you want to learn more about vehicle to grid, check out this video or this video. And if you want to learn about Neuralink, check out this video. Thank you so much for watching.